नमस्ते, मायसेल्फ कृष्ण मिश्रा फ्रॉम इंडिया मेट्रोलॉजिकल डिपार्टमेंट। आई एम गोइंग टू प्रेजेंट वीकली वेदर रिव्यू एंड आउटलुक फॉर नेक्स्ट 2 वीक्स। ड्यूरिंग द लास्ट 1 वीक, एज वी कैन सी फ्रॉम दिस पिक्चर, देर वॉज एन एक्टिव वेस्टर्न डिस्टर्बेंस विच कॉज्ड वेदर एक्टिविटी ड्यूरिंग 11th to 13th ओवर वेस्टर्न हिमालयन रीजन एंड एडजॉइनिंग प्लेन्स ऑफ नॉर्थ वेस्ट इंडिया, पंजाब, हरियाणा, राजस्थान एंड ऑल्सो ओवर मध्य प्रदेश एंड वेस्टर्न पार्ट्स ऑफ उत्तर प्रदेश। ड्यूरिंग दिस 11th to 13th March पीरियड आइसोलेटेड हिल स्टॉर्म एक्टिविटी वॉज ऑल्सो ऑब्जर्व्ड ओवर पंजाब, हरियाणा, राजस्थान एंड मध्य प्रदेश। And this WD, along with this WD, there was also an induced cyclonic circulation over Rajasthan. And as we know that whenever there is a western disturbance, the western disturbances move eastwards and their remnants cause weather over northeast India. So during the period starting from 11th of March to up to 15th of March, there was fairly widespread rainfall over Arunachal Pradesh and isolated to scattered rainfall activity was there over Assam and Meghalaya and Nagaland, Manipur, Mizoram and Tripura. So now we come over to the weather realized. We can see this is the animation, weekly animation of cloud moving from 11th March up to 17th of March, and this is the observed rainfall product from India Meteorological Department GFS, home run GFS model. So here we can see that on 11th March there was over sub-Himalayan West Bengal and Sikkim up to 5 cm rainfall was observed. Over Tamil Nadu and Kerala heavy rainfall was also observed on due to active easterly wave, speed convergence of the easterly wave. And on 12th of March, there was heavy rainfall and heavy snowfall was observed over higher reaches of Jammu and Kashmir. And over 13th March, we can see that there was active weather conditions over East India and adjoining parts of East Madhya Pradesh. And as we can see, this is the picture which shows weekly observed rainfall scenario. So we can see that due to that active western disturbance along with the lower level trough which caused weather activity over western Himalayan region and plains of northwest India and central India. So we can see that this blue color is showing normal to above normal rainfall activity over Madhya Pradesh and over Kerala. So we can see here that the percentage departure from the long period average over central India is around 5% plus 5%, but over all other three regions it is deficient. And for a pre-monsoon season as a whole, from which starts from 1st of March, from 1st March to 17th March, we can see that the rainfall is deficient over all the 4 regions and as a consequence over the country as a whole as well. This is the synoptic condition for today. We can see there is a feeble western disturbance over Jammu and Kashmir, there is a cyclonic circulation over East Rajasthan, there is another cyclonic circulation over Marathwada and neighborhood, and there is a trough over East India along 80 degree longitude. But all these systems are quite feeble and due to these systems no active weather conditions are expected except over the central India. Over the central India, thunderstorm activity is going on. There is also mid-level moisture incursion from the Arabian Sea and lower level moisture incursion due to anticyclone situated over North Bay of Bengal to the central parts of the country, and due to that thunderstorm activity is continued over Madhya Pradesh and adjoining areas of Maharashtra. This is the observed temperature scenario for the last 1 week. As we can see that there were thunderstorm activity over central India, there was a easterly wave activity over southern parts of the country, and there was active WD in the start of the week. So we can see that these yellow colors and these are the cool colors, which are showing that the temperatures have been, maximum temperatures have been either normal or just above normal. So pleasant weather conditions were observed during the week. And now we come over to the rainfall forecast summary for week 1 and week 2. So during the week 1, as we have little bit we have discussed that there is wind discontinuity lying over the peninsular India. There is a mid-level trough over the Arabian Sea which is pumping moisture into the mid-level over the central India, over Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra. So due to that, right from today up to 21st of March, so during next 3-4 days, there is a good weather activity expected over Madhya Pradesh and Maharashtra and adjoining Telangana as well. And during the same time, from 21st, an active western disturbance is going to affect western Himalayan region, and at the same time there is also easterly waves, easterly winds, although they are quite calm, but there will be weather activity during 21st of March to 24th of March over the Himalayan region and the plains, Punjab, Haryana, Rajasthan and West UP. This is the anomaly chart. So we can see that these colors, cool colors, are showing that the rainfall activity will be above normal over this northwest India, over central parts of India and over extreme southern peninsula, that is over Tamil Nadu and Kerala. These are the mean sea level charts, and this is the 850 HP wind product from IMD GFS home run model. So after looking into the forecast summary for week 1, from this picture we can go into the location specific warning over the entire country. So we can see that on 18th of March, thunderstorm and which is depicted by the yellow color, and hailstorm which is depicted by orange color, is going on over your Madhya Pradesh region, and thunderstorm activity is very likely over Chhattisgarh and Telangana and northern parts of coastal Andhra Pradesh. Tomorrow this activity is likely to become more active, and we can see that areas of Madhya Pradesh, Vidarbha, Marathwada and Telangana may experience isolated hailstorm activity along with thunderstorm activity at a few places, and over Madhya Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh and Odisha, thunderstorm activity is expected. On 20th, the same activity will continue, although with lesser severity, and we can see that over Marathwada and Telangana, isolated hailstorm activity is probable, and all over other areas of Madhya Pradesh and of Madhya Maharashtra, the isolated thunderstorm activity with interior Karnataka as well is very likely. On 21st March, this activity over the peninsular, North Peninsular India is going to be subdued, but from the same day, an active western disturbance is very likely to affect, actually from the night of 20th of March, and which may cause on 21st March hailstorm activity over Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh, and thunderstorm activity over northern parts of Punjab. And on 22nd of March, this activity is going to be intensified further, and over Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand, Himachal Pradesh, isolated hailstorm activity is also probable along with thunderstorm at a few places. And we can see that over Himachal Pradesh on 22nd, on 23rd, isolated heavy rainfall is probable on 22nd over Himachal Pradesh, and on 22nd and 23rd over, isolated heavy rainfall and snowfall is probable over Jammu and Kashmir on 22nd and 23rd. Jammu and Kashmir, Gilgit, Baltistan, Muzaffarabad and Ladakh region. So this is the rainfall summary for week 2. As we can see, as we have discussed, there is no active western disturbance approaching the Indian region in the week 2. And the same is depicted by this color, this map, and we can see that although there will be feeble western disturbances approaching and impacting the western Himalayan region, but as we can see this anomaly color from here, that the rainfall anomaly will be negative only. It's not going to over to these colors, blue colors. It's going towards yellow and red colors. But southern parts of Kerala and Tamil Nadu, due to easterly, lower level easterly speed convergence, southern parts of Kerala and Tamil Nadu are very likely to have isolated to scattered rainfall activity, which will cause above normal activity over these southern peninsular region. And now we come over to the temperature forecast summary for week 1. So from here we can see these are the temperatures forecasted, and here we can see that what is the anomaly over the country. So here, due to going on this thunderstorm activity, and right from today and up to 21st, 22nd, we can see that temperatures are likely to remain below normal over this region, over Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra and over Karnataka, Telangana and Rayalaseema region. And all other parts of the country temperatures are likely to remain above normal at some parts by 2 to 3 and some over 3 to 4 and 4 to 5 at isolated parts as well. During week 2, since there is no active western disturbance expected, so there will remain almost dry weather conditions over the country, and due to that, these temperatures over northwest India, east India and northeast India are likely to rise and become above normal by around 4 to 5 degrees. And over this north peninsular region, the temperatures would also rise, but they would remain in the below normal category. So this is these are our apps for Android platform and for iOS platform. Mausam app for location specific weather warnings, Damini app for lightning alert, and Meghdoot app for agro advisory services. So on both, users of both platforms can download their respective apps and use our weather services. We are also on Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and we also have a blog, and our website is mausam.imd.gov.in, as you all know very well. And we have also launched recently the initiative of crowdsourcing. We can see that by here you can going on to this webpage, you can any weather you have observed, by selecting the state and the respective areas, you can give that weather, and by clicking over these specific items, you can submit the weather you have expected. So that will enhance our weather services and weather skills. Thank you very much.